A very good morning to all of you listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, Seek the Soul, the Truth Lies Within. The link is given down below with the YouTube link. For all those who are listening to it on Instagram, you can go and check out on that link. There are other playlists also which take you towards yogasins, which take you towards flexibility and diet and sleep and relationships and much more. Just go ahead and explore, and do remember to share it with others also if you find it worthwhile. So let's go ahead with today's blessing, 207th day of our godly blessing, where God as a teacher wants us to become the true teacher. I can also share a lot of things with you on this, but if I don't have a good character, if I don't have the good thoughts and words and actions, then it's of no use. So let's understand what does God have to say in this blessing. Teach others through your form, not just words, but form. What comes under the form? Let's explore that. As a worthy and capable teacher. So, there are two kinds of teacher. Students who respect the teacher because that teacher is kind, humble, has a lot of knowledge, and respects everybody else and has got qualities in that teacher. But there are other kind of teachers who might have the ego, who might flaunt their knowledge, and that's the reason why other people, the children or the students, don't like them or don't appreciate them at all. So liking, disliking happens. Knowledge is the same, but somebody has a character, somebody has bad character, somebody has got good character. So that makes a difference. Let's understand in details what does Baba have to say. Worthy and capable teachers are said to be those who teach through their own forms. Their forms are full of teachings. Their way of seeing and moving will teach others. Seeing others, moving. So, some people have ways of manipulating. They see through the eyes. They look at you in a certain way. But something else is going on in their mind. Some people move as if they're going to help you. But they're doing the opposite actually. Their intention is something else. So, what kind of teacher would that be? So Baba says, their way of seeing and moving will teach others. You saw in the Sakar form, Sakar means physical form, we saw Brahma Baba, or the first child of God. How did he see, how did he eat, how did he move, everything. In today's world, we try to, generally people, they try to copy the actors in the way they move, the way they speak the dialogues, the way they act and everything, right? And generally, in this Kali Yuga, it's more about violence, it's more about putting the other person down, or showing heroism in the form of beating people around, the bad guys, and that's what feel that we need to copy all that. Some of them, they do that, youngsters, but then as in when they become wise, they start looking for good role models. In the beginning, the role models are the parents. If the parents shout at each other, amongst each other, if the parents fight or quarrel amongst each other, if they show kiddish or childish behavior, the children think that that is what they need to do. That is the way of putting or bringing a person into the right place. So a child, a male child, might learn that, and when he grows up, when he gets married, he might think that to put the wife in the right place would be to shout at her, to scream at her, to call her names, and to bring her in the right place. Now what kind of form is that? What kind of character is that? So that's what we learn from our parents also, and from the, you know, from the place where we go for our learning, a school, a university, a campus. So a lot of role models are required in this world, and Brahma Baba or Adam was one of the role models. Now, Baba says, at every step, every action was in a practical way, in the form of the teacher. So Brahma Baba used to not just talk, but also act or enact in the same way. If he spoke about humility, if he spoke about contentment, he never complained. If he spoke about humility, he was always humble. Even if somebody who was younger to him, much more younger to him in physical age, but he was so soul conscious, but even if somebody was younger and he said something which could spoil his mood, Brahma Baba's mood, but he was still humble to listen to it and be kind enough to again reply back in a very, very simple, kind manner. So that was seen by others. It was not just taught by Brahma Baba through words, but also seen in his actions. So people could copy it. People could feel that, yes, it is possible to do that. Okay, that's how you do it. So that's what Baba says, that you also become that form. So Baba says, in other words, you would call it a divine activity. It is a common thing to teach others with words, yes, but everyone wants to have an experience. of don't just talk but show how to be humble, show how to be kind, show how to be content, show how to be a royal being, show how to be somebody who accepts others, others' mistakes, others' goodness, show that how do you accept everybody's flaws and still be loving and kind, and how to be detached from the outcome of expecting something from them. Show it to others. Don't just talk about it, God says. And that's what we try to see in Brahmakumaris. We try to see those souls who are walking and talking this spiritual knowledge and not just talking. So God says, with the power of your elevated actions and elevated thoughts, give everyone an experience. So actions and thoughts. So thoughts cannot be seen by you, what am I thinking inside, but my actions can talk about it, right? But actions we get to know after they are done. Thoughts come first, then come the actions. So if my thoughts are pure and powerful, then my actions, my eyes, the way I see, the way you see, the way you speak, the way you hear, everything will change. Otherwise, words say something else, actions say something else. That's what needs to be brought in alignment. That's where we become powerful. So today's blessing was all about checking ourselves whether we are just words or we are also actions. I leave you with this beautiful vartan. Have a blessed day. Stay safe. Stay home. Om Shanti.